Tess, it's always lovely to see you.
Likewise. My tra-
Where did you get to? Give me the gossip.
It's been all about learning new skills, but most importantly, long story short, I've written down everything I-
Oh, I don't know about this.
Don't be shy. I'll put the blueprint books over there.
Thanks, I think.
Turmeric. I hope this will give you the intro to crafting that you so badly need. Tess. The great philosopher Plato, I think, once said, crafting is the process of putting things together to make slightly better things. When a customer strides in and they want something crafting, they'll walk to and stand patiently at the crafting counter. An icon, like this, shows a customer's order. Get started by looking up how to make it in the recipe book. Wander on close to open the book. Then select to make a staff. You need to work with a log on a crafting bench. Grab a log from the pile. Next, place it on the crafting. I'm not an expert in the a staff. Fantastically useful for prodding customers or pretending you're a bit of a wizard or something. Pick up your new staff and hand it over to the waiting customer. Now for the unimportant part, getting paid. Some foolish customers don't want to haggle. Instead, just well done. Enjoy your vast, vast profits. Next up, pottery. Get back to the recipe book and get it looked up. Pick up some clay first. Here is a little lesser-known trick. You can press the throw button. Anyhow, pick up the clay again and place it in the furnace. Then, do the same with a piece of coal. Start baking, press the probe. The best thing about furnaces is you don't need to hang around while they bake. Just come back when they're done. Trying your best not to drop or violently throw the pottery, give it to the waiting customer. Every customer you serve without making a mistake will bump up your multiplier. Keep it going and you'll end up with much more money. That's it. Close this book and get crafting. Be good, Merrick. Tess.